fabulous three rank holders from the latest November 17 attempt who are going to help you for the preparation tips and how to manage that important 1.5 day. So starting.
Hi guys, I'm Natali Bhandari. I got AIR 10.
Hi guys, I'm Shivam Keswani. I got AIR 29.
Hi guys, I'm Bhumika Satra. I got AIR 17.
So guys, starting from the material, we advise you to study or to refer ICI material. And for old students, you have practice manuals. They are the best for last day's preparation. And for new students, just do your ICI material. And please don't forget to read revised test papers, revision test papers. So guys, starting with accounts, you'll have 3 to 4 days. So firstly, keep your focus on practice manual. And please don't read AIs because they'll help you fetch 20 marks easily. Also keep your paper neat and clean because presentation matters a lot. And in the first 15 minutes when you get that reading time, please recite the sequence of questions you'll be attempting. Because if you start your paper with the question you're most confident about, it gives a nice impression to the examiner. And please don't spend too much time on one particular question. Just if you're stuck somewhere, just leave that and start with the next question.
I think Natalia has very well covered most of the points regarding presentation and the sequence in which one should attempt the paper. Now talking about law and especially for the old core students, I think ethics and communication is one part in which you should focus in that 1.5 day. Talking about me personally, I completed that part first, and credits to Wings of Fire Notes. The link we will attach in the description. Then talking about the other laws, I focused more on the business laws because I found them to be less time consuming and they were more scoring. And company law, I just went through the answers from practice manual because I think ICI prefers, and the marking scheme is also prepared from that material only. And then coming to the last day revision, I went through the negotiable act from one of the famous author's book which students generally refer. And in the end, I'll just say that in the law, the focus should be on presentation. I'm not talking about the subject जो जनरली बच्चों को परेशान कर देता है. मिताली बताएगी क्योंकि उसका मेरे से एक नंबर ज़्यादा आया था, तो ये 1% घटा बता पाएगी.
तो गाइस, फॉर टैक्स बेसिकली आवर पेपर वाज वेरी अनएक्सपेक्टेड, सो प्लीज डोंट पैनिक इफ यू सी सम क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आई हैव नेवर सीन. जस्ट डू इट. और गाइस प्लीज अमेंडमेंट्स को मत भूलना, दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड आई थिंक यू गाइस हैव टू मेनी
अमेंडमेंट्स,
सो प्लीज keep your focus on amendments too. और course बहुत ज़्यादा है, सारा cover नहीं भी हो पाता है, तो don't panic, just go with a calm mind and I think you'll nail the paper.
और cost FM का paper कैसा भी हो, चिंता मत करना, tax का अच्छे से कर लेना.
Don't let any of your previous paper affect your coming paper. That's the key.
ठीक है, tax के बाद आता है advanced accounts.
So advanced accounts is pretty easy for everyone, but the thing that happens is after you give paper for taxation, you tend to lose your energy after
stamina
taxation. Yeah. So please maintain that stamina and just revise all the concepts that you have done in advance. And obviously focus on AIs, focus on story, and you will definitely score good marks in advanced accounts.
See, advanced accounts के लिए one thing I would like to emphasize, ICI ने ना packages बना रखे हैं. सो अगर आपको लगता है कि एडवांस अकाउंट का आपका सिलेबस कंप्लीट हुआ नहीं है या कम हुआ है, तो आप पैकेज स्टडी करके चले जाओ. जैसे मैं एक बार बताया था क्या क्या पैकेजेस हैं. AS आता है 20 मार्क्स का, पार्टनरशिप 16 मार्क्स का. देन व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑडिट, आई थिंक वन थिंग दैट द एग्जामिनर लुक्स फॉर इन द पेपर इज कि बच्चे ने आंसर लिखते हुए स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑन ऑडिटिंग या कंपनी अकाउंट्स की, कंपनी ऑडिट की अगर बात करें, तो सेक्शन रेफर किया है कि नहीं. सो इन दिस 1.5 डेज डू गो थ्रू द स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑन ऑडिटिंग वन, सो दैट अगर पेपर में कोई क्वेश्चन आता है, यू आर एबल टू मेंशन इट. एंड कंपनी ऑडिट पे अच्छा फोकस रखना, कंपनी ऑडिट इज वेरी स्कोरिंग. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट वाउचिंग एंड वेरिफिकेशन, डू मेंशन द कीवर्ड्स दैट आर मेंशन्ड इन प्रैक्टिस मैनुअल. कई बार लोग कहते हैं कि यार इसका तो काफी आंसर जनरल सा होता है, या कुछ पर्टिकुलर वो 3-4 लाइन बना के दे देते हैं, इसको पेल देना, तुम्हारे ऑडिट नंबर आ जाएंगे वाउचिंग वेरिफिकेशन में. ऐसा नहीं है. इफ यू प्रिपेयर द आंसर वेल, इफ यू प्रेजेंट इट वेल, यू विल डेफिनेटली स्कोर मार्क्स. एंड बीइंग अ थ्योरी पेपर, हैंड राइटिंग थोड़ी लेजिबल रखना, सो दैट द एग्जामिनर इज एबल टू रीड इट एंड डजंट गेट इरिटेटेड. दैट्स ऑल अबाउट ऑडिट. शी विल टेक ओवर.
सो गाइस, फॉर आईटीएसएम, आईटीएसएम इज द like unpredictable paper. You can't really remember everything, but try to keep your focus on the most important keywords. There are certain keywords which you should mention in your answer, and they are going to definitely help you to fetch marks. उसके बाद guys, PM में सब कुछ cover नहीं है. Basically हमने जो notice किया है कि हमारा paper PM के बाहर से था, तो please थोड़ा बहुत study material या other notes को refer करना.
So basically यही कहना चाहती है, जो institute के material में जो headings दी होती है ना, वो अच्छे से करके जाना. अंदर का तो देखो यार, सब बनाते ही हैं, वो उनको भी पता है.
So guys, we know this is a very stressful time and you guys must be panicking about the upcoming exams, but we want to tell you, just be calm, just have the courage to go for it, and even if you feel that you haven't prepared enough for group 2, just go for it, just give it a try, and it will definitely help you to get set off. And also always have someone by your side, meet your parents, meet your friends, anyone, to discuss situations, to discuss your problems. It will help you a lot.
Even if you don't have such companion, Rings of Fire is with you
always.